man, well, today's the day. The new Endgame movie finally comes out, and after one whole year of speculating, there's no way this movie's gonna be even more sadder than Infinity War. Depressing. Avengers Endgame is the one film that I've been waiting for to see for an entire year. It's clearly not a film that I've been speculating about, anticipating about, collecting, or I don't know, thinking about in the back burner of my mind for an entire year. Yeah, now it's here and it's over and wow. Okay, it looks like I don't like this movie. No, I love this film. It is amazing. There's never been a film like this in my life. All I could talk about is all the moments that I really enjoyed. Obviously, it's not a perfect film and there's a lot of flaws, but I mean, come on. It is a comic book movie that has never been made before, where you have every single superhero from the past 11 years culminate together to kill Thanos. Now, I know there's like a few issues that I can think of on the top of my head, like, oh, it's Thanos from 2014, that's the one that they're fighting, not the present day one, because he gets killed in the beginning of the movie. I'm fine with that. They're both totally different perspectives on stuff. Thanos in the Infinity War filled with what he needed, while the other one in 2014 was just freshly coming up with his plan with using the stones. So it's whatever. The thing I really liked about this movie is how it feels like the second act of a two-act story, first being Infinity War and this being Endgame. And then within this own movie, breaks off into three parts: a epilogue for Infinity War, a time travel story, which is their last adventure with the original Avengers, and lastly, the conclusion fights and an epilogue for every single character, whether it is a good conclusion or not, it concludes it. And yeah, I really enjoyed how they did with every character. This series, if you're going by the Russo Brothers viewing order for the films, technically Captain America is the first movie. And when you think about it, the first scene, the first stuff in this series, it begins in 1940. This movie ends in 1940 with Cap being dancing with Peggy. It all goes full circle with him, and I really love that resolution for him. With Iron Man, he grew up like realizing his weapons were a force of destruction, and then after Avengers, could never get one good ounce of sleep worrying about what's to come. And the way it ends with his character dying is that he could finally rest now that everything's concluded. And I thought that was very beautiful. Sad, one of the many scenes that I cried in, but I really enjoyed it. With Black Widow, a character that I didn't really like that much in Iron Man 2, I grew to love throughout this whole series. And so with her giving up herself to save like everyone in the universe to get the Soul Stone, I thought that was very like beautiful, yet very sad. It's a character that I'm gonna miss a lot. I know there's a movie coming out with her, but it just feels very conclusive with her, and I'm just saddened by her being gone. With Thor, I don't like how people complain about him being fat. When you think about the whole structure of what's been going on with this guy, is that he lost his mom in the second movie, the second Thor movie. He lost his dad in Homeworld and Thor Ragnarok. He lost his best friend and brother in Infinity War, and then he failed to kill Thanos. And on top of all that, being in this movie, he still kills Thanos and still doesn't fix up anything. That alone would make anyone a complete wreck, especially a 1,000-year-old god. So I really like that they made him a little bit fat. It wasn't more comedic, it was just to show how depressed he was. And if anything, he also kind of reminded me of what he looks like in the comic books, with how he looks, eventually he's gonna look like his dad with a little bit of a gut and a thicker beard. So I thought that was kind of neat. The stuff with Hawkeye, here's a character we haven't seen in 3 years. And the first 5 minutes, they bring you back into why we should care about him, and why we do care about him is because he's a loving father for his kids, and they're all gone, including his wife. And It's such a tragic moment, and you feel for the guy throughout the whole movie. I don't know. I enjoyed his time. I love Jeremy Renner in this movie. He was really great. So in terms of moments, I mean, come on. So Captain America getting Thor's hammer, all the funny jokes within the whole series, such as I can do this all day or the Hail Hydra line. This movie was surprisingly funny. For a movie that ended the way it did in Infinity War, I was surprised that it was hilarious as it was. There wasn't one bad joke in this film. As opposed to Age of Ultron, where the jokes didn't feel like they fit in with the characters and there was always quips every 2 minutes, here the jokes went with the characters and it felt like it just went with the story, and I enjoyed it. So the biggest thing that happens in this movie is obviously every freaking hero shows up in the ending. Dude, it's insane. Like, it is something I've been waiting for to see since I was a kid. Obviously, we do get like stuff like that growing up with the Spider-Man animated series or Earth's Mightiest Heroes, and obviously a lot of event moments in comic books, but it's something you want to see in a live action film that at first seemed like it was impossible, but here we are, and it is the coolest thing I've ever seen. Even characters that I didn't even notice until a few hours ago, like the Ravagers or Howard the Duck show up. It's crazy. And then obviously, like, there's a lot of moments too, like Cap getting his hammer, and I already said that. Yeah, honestly, I just forgot. For a movie that has a lot to deal with time travel and it being the finale, this left in a lot more questions than answers. And obviously, I don't know any of this stuff. What I'll try to do is explain it right now. I'm dumb. Well, in conclusion, it's not just the best comic book movie or the best Marvel movie, it's just a really, really good movie. Is it flawless? No, it has its problems, but the good doesn't outweigh the bad. Neither the bad outweigh the good, you know? It is a really good film. It is an event. It is literally the one thing that I'm really glad that they did was keeping all the spoilers and keeping everything to themselves about what happens in this movie. I really enjoyed it. This is something that's been around my life since I was in high school when I first saw Iron Man and saw the after credits scene and the possibilities of seeing all these heroes together, and now we're here. I really loved it, and I give it like a 12 out of 10. That sounds like a dumb number, but it exceeds my expectations. It's really good. My only problem is, as a fanboy, this is what I've been waiting for, and now it's here, and I don't know what to do as a fan about that. What can you do after this? I'm excited for the future of Marvel, but at the moment I'm kind of like bummed out because I don't know what's going to happen. But I don't know. I mean, what else is there?
Hey Mark, what's wrong?
It's all over, Brian, okay? Endgame's out, there's no more Marvel stuff. I mean, what am I supposed to watch? DC? Like with Hellboy?
Mark, you realize that Spider-Man Far From Home is in 2 months, there's a Black Widow movie, and other Marvel films on Disney Plus.
What? I mean... Oh yeah!